Good day everyone, welcome to another Quickedit video, this time with a very hazy mountain landscape from the German Alps. This shot was quite hard to edit for me, but I think the end result will look pretty cool with a way stronger golden hour light and way stronger contrast as well. So let's go. First off, you can see I'm in the Camera Raw editor. Here I'm starting by changing the white balance. And since I want to have golden hour light, I'm going to increase the temperature slightly. Just a bit, that should be enough. Next, I want to work on dehazing this image. Of course, I could just use the slider, but I think this looks a bit strange. So I'm going to approach this a little differently. First off, I'm dropping the shadows, which already helps. As I said, I want to have a lot of contrast, so my plan is to overexpose the upper part on purpose, because you see there isn't anything interesting anyway, and we get this very cool gradient from overexposed to underexposed in the foreground basically. So for the next step, let's just boost the highlights. It does add a little bit more haze, but I think it's good for now. Okay, let's see. I could play around with the exposure as well, bringing it down a bit. And then I'm also playing around with the whites at the same time, just trying to get the contrast right for this image. And I think that's a good spot to work with. You can see the settings here are very, very unusual. I don't think I ever dropped the exposure all the way down here, but in this case, I just think it works. But I do want to have a little more brightness in the darker parts, so I'm increasing the blacks. So something like this, maybe. All right. Now I do want to keep some of the hazy look, and for this reason, I'm going to drop the texture as well as the clarity and the dehaze. The dehaze will make things brighter, so be careful here. But that looks really, really cool already. Let's check the before version. You can see that's a huge difference. And now you can also see what I mean by overexposing the upper part. And thus I'm just creating a very cool light effect. All right, let's continue. I do have a few local adjustments applied here. Let's start with the gradiated filters. First off, I want to work on the upper part. Let's see, maybe I'm bringing down the highlights just a bit, so the light bleed over the trees isn't that heavy. Something like this maybe. And also I'm going to drop the contrast here. This will add a little more haze in the background, which works really nice on this landscape. All right, then let's check out the foreground real quick. And you can see there's not much going on. We have a huge black area, which I don't want to change, but I want to add some light to this grassy field up on this ridge right there. To target this specific area, I'm going to make use of a luminance range mask. And since I only want to target the brightest parts of this area down there, I'm going to filter out the blacks by pushing this slider right here to the right. I only need the very bright highlights. And to get a softer gradient around this luminance range, I'm going to add a little bit of smoothness. Just like that. Now let's see what happens if we are pushing the exposure. You can see it mostly affects the area which gets hit by the sunlight. Maybe let's zoom in a little bit and try to clean this up. So with the gradiated filter selected, I'm going to hit the erase button right there. And I want to just soften the edge here. All right, just like that. Now that's it for the gradiated filters. Again, it did help quite a bit in making this image look cooler. So then there is one radial filter just above this image. And again, you can see this mostly affects this overexposed area in the sky. So I want to add some stronger golden hour light. again, I'm just using some temperature here. I don't want to make it too heavy, but just a little bit like this. And maybe I'm going to further drop the highlights here, as well as the exposure. But again, to add a little bit of glow, I'm going to increase the blacks. Perfect. So the upper area is still overexposed, but now we can see this little mountain in the back. Maybe I'm going to erase that later. For now, I'm not sure about that. So that's it for the local adjustments. Let's do a little bit of color grading, and I'm skipping most of the things and I'm heading straight to the split toning. For the midtones and for the highlights, I'm going to apply a warm golden-like color tone. Let's see, something like this with a bit less saturation. Okay, then let's do the same on the highlights. And I think that looks good. Then I'm not going to sharpen this image. I want to head straight into Photoshop. So let's open it. The Photoshop part for this image will be rather complex. Let's start with the easiest thing first, and that is to get rid of the sensor spots using the spot healing brush. Okay, that looks good. Next up, I want to try and add some kind of light rays shining through the trees. I'm not sure how this will work, but let's just duplicate that layer first. And now let's see, I think I'm going to apply a Gaussian blur as the first step, just like that. Okay, and then let's again go to blur and add a radial blur filter here. Of course, we want to have a zoom blur with the best quality and the most amount. I'm going to adjust the blur center to be somewhere in the sky like this, and let's hit okay. I do think this works quite good actually. Of course, however, we don't want this radial blur on the whole image, so I'm adding a layer mask, use a black brush, and now I'm just getting rid of a few areas right here. Especially in the foreground, I don't want to have this effect. So I'm just carefully working my ray through this image. Okay, that looks good to me. So we mostly have those light rays in the center part, which also will make those areas a little more hazy. I think that's okay. But of course, that's totally a personal taste thing right here. So next up, let's make this grassy patch in the foreground a little brighter. Therefore, I'm creating a new layer, switch the blending mode to overlay. And with this overlay layer, I'm going to dodge this area. For this reason, I'm going to use the TK panel plugin. And this plugin allows me to specifically target this bright spot right there. I'm going to apply a lights one layer mask on this overlay layer. And with a white brush and a lowered opacity, I am going to paint over this area. So you can see this also affects the area close to this. To fix that, I'm simply going to use the eraser and brush over this. Just like that. I could duplicate that layer by hitting Ctrl J and make it even brighter. Again, I want to make use of the eraser though, just to clean things up a little bit. Now I do think the top part could use some more glow. Let's apply a new layer and this time go with the soft light blending mode and pick up the color from the sky. Let's see, it's almost pure white. I want to add a little bit more warmth here. And now on the soft light layer, I'm just carefully painting in a little glow just above the trees. Okay, that should be good. Now, as I mentioned, the Photoshop part for this image is a bit more complex than usual. In order to be able to go back to certain steps of the editing process, I'm now not going to merge all those layers. Instead, I'm again using the TK panel plugin and I am creating a new layer which basically combines all the layers beneath it by pressing this button right here. So all the steps from those layers are in this new layer. Now what I want to do next is I want to adjust the proportions of the image. For this reason, I'm going to hit Ctrl T and then right click in here and select Warp. I want to make this shot a little more symmetrical. That means I'm going to drag up the mountain on the right side, just like that. Drag it down in the center a little bit. And also drag it down here to stretch it a little more vertically. And so I'm just shaping the landscape a little differently. Just like that. Let me turn off this layer so you can see the difference. It's a much, much more balanced image. Before that, everything was kind of leaning to the right. Now it's perfectly centered, so it's a much more pleasing composition. Then next up, why not add a little bit of haze? Let me create a new layer. Again, I'm going with the overlay blending mode for this one. And again, I want to use a luminance range mask here. In this case, I am going to target the midtones. Let's try this one and apply it on our new overlay layer. And to add a little bit of fog, I'm actually going to use a fog brush. Let's see what we have here. Also, I'm setting the foreground color to white. Increase the brush opacity a little bit. Now I'm just carefully painting in. Again, that is very, very subtle here, but I think it does a pretty good job. Let's add one more layer again with the overlay blending mode, but this time I'm not using a layer mask here. So I just need to be a bit more careful. Just playing around with the brush tool. Okay, that looks really, really cool, I guess. Again, I'm going to use the merge visible option of the TK panel. With this layer, I do want to check the Nick Collection plugin. So first off, we have the polarization effect here, which adds a little more saturation to the image. I think it looks better with it. Let's go with that. Then let's add one more filter. In this case, a classical soft focus could be very cool. So I'm going with the third soft focus method, but I'm bringing down the strength a bit here. And I only really want it back there over the sky part. Maybe just like that. Let's add one more point here. I think that's pretty good. Let's apply it like that. All right, perfect. And that's post-processing for this mountainscape image. I hope this was interesting and helpful. If you have any questions about the editing, let me know in the comments. And thank you so much for watching this video.